You are reading from the book of Romans. Romans 1, verse 18 goes on. Just to let man know that man knows the truth. For the what? For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men, who hold the truth in unrighteousness. Because that which may be known of God is manifest in them. For God has shown unto them the invincible thing of faith from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even the eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Because that when the new God, they glorify it not as God, neither was thankful, but became dead in their own imagination, and the foolish heart was darkened, professing themselves to be wise, they became fools, and changed the glory of the incorruptible God into an image like bird and faces of beasts and creeping things. Therefore God also gave them up to uncleanliness thought. The lust of their own heart to dishonor their own body between themselves. They changed the truth of God into a lie, and worship and serve the creature more than the Creator who is blessed forever. Amen. For this cause God gave them up unto their affection. So even the women betrayed the natural use into that which is a great nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of a woman, in the lust towards one another, man with man, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves the recompense of the ear which is mean. And even as they did like to repay God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobative mind. A reprobative mind to do those things which are not covenant. These things with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, malvanity, witchcraft, backbiting, haters of God, disrespectful, proud, boasters, exempted of evil things, disobedient to their parents, without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, impossible and merciful. Who knows the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death. Not only do we sin, but we have pleasure in doing this thing. Now if you look at them, you can see that the time is shocking. The man is no lover of the self, the flesh, not of God. The man dishonors the Godhead of God himself and glorifying the creature that God created under his feet, that God put under his feet, that is loved as an angel. Man glorifies the creature more than the Creator, who is blessed forevermore. That's why we look around and we see in the heads of government that the Father, the Word of God, and better men that a man can marry to a man and a woman into a woman. But when we look back in Genesis 1, we realize and we know for sure that God created man and woman. Indeed, he is a righteous. He has created you because he wants you to do what he wants. He gave us a law that we should obey the law. And we look around and we see that a man will go into another man, and a woman will go into another woman. And today, he's telling us that today is the end of time we have lived. We have lived in perilous times at the end of time. This is the time that God is coming and is going to destroy this earth. Hallelujah. God is going to destroy this earth, and he's telling us,
I was doing that one.
They got a line. They got a line. They got a line.
everybody gets a chance.